remember, we're continuing to talk about end behavior. So the end behavior is just saying, where does the graph go as you go out to positive and negative infinity or to the right or left? Make sure you're all phones away, please. Running games are done. Hey! Hello. Thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Did you get this for today?
Yes.
For college algebra?
Yes. This is the worksheet.
Oh, the one that you said.
Okay. This is what I saw at work.
Well,
I forgot to print mine up.
This is what I
right
now? No.
Okay.
I've got kids in my class taking
pictures. Oh, you do?
Yes.
Oh, cool. All right. I'll take care of that. Thank you.
Sure.
Yeah, I knew you gave me two of them.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this is what you would say.
Yes. Thank you. All right. Let's run through what this homework was. Shh. End behavior. Remember, it talks about what's happening to the right and the left. And then we started talking about the solutions. And the solutions are where crosses the x-axis. The crossing of the y-axis is not that important of a point, but it does help you determine what the shape of the graph is looking like. Remember, the solutions and the crossing of the x-axis could be the same thing. If it bounces off the x-axis, that means that you have the same binomial once it's factored down multiple times that are even. So if you had, like, you know, it happened at 5 four times, it's going to bounce. If it happens at 5 three times, it'll go right through it. So just running through these questions real quick. 1 through 6. So if you look at problem number 1, it says, what's the maximum number of real zeros? Well, problem number 1, you have x to the fifth in there and has a whole bunch of other stuff. So the maximum number of zeros that you'll have is 5. The maximum number of times it crosses the x-axis is also 5. And then the maximum number of turning points is 4. It's always 1 less than the highest exponent. You got to be careful. We don't always have them in, they don't always write in order. So be aware, you're looking for the highest exponent wherever it falls. Problem number 2, it looks like it has, you have negative x to the 6th power as your highest exponent for number 2. It's not in order. So the maximum number of solutions is 6. The maximum number of times it crosses the x-axis is 6. The maximum number of turning points is 5. Okay? So this graph would actually look, actually not like that because it's negative, it will look like this somehow, or it actually looked like 1, 2, like that, where here's a turning point, each one of these are turning points, or they're relative max or mins or extremas or, you know, different names they give it. So I think you're starting to figure out in math, they give things different names. One country calls it one thing and then it starts, they get the bombs and everyone starts calling it that. Number 3. Your highest exponent is x to the 10th, so the maximum number of solutions is 10. Maximum number of x-axis crossings is 10. The maximum number of turning points is 9. So it should be pretty easy as you go through. Problem number 4, it's raised to the 3rd power. The maximum number of zeros is 3. The maximum number of times across the x-axis is 3. The maximum number of turning points is 2. Problem number 5, you have x to the negative x to the 3rd. Maximum number of solutions, 3. Maximum number of times across the x-axis, 3. Maximum turning points, 2. Problem number 6, it's raised to the 4th power. Maximum solutions, 4. Maximum x-axis crossing, 4. Maximum number of turning points, 3. Okay? And that's what those basically deal with. And then we went to 1 through 17. So then after that, they wanted you to figure out what these graphs look like. So you had this, you had this, you had this. Notice I'm not too worried about what's in the middle. So this particular problem, this is just going to be a parabola. It looks like that. So you have to figure out which one is the parabola that opens up that crosses at negative 5 on the y-axis. Okay? So in that case, looks like it's going to be B. This one, this is raised to the sixth power, but you have a negative out front, so it's going to look like that. Okay? Things that we want to know, it crosses the y-axis at negative 3, so if everyone opens upside down, they both go down. That crosses at negative 3. That'd make it real easy on us. I'd say A. It's the only one close. And then number 9, you had x to the 5th. So this is going to look something like this, where it's going to cross the x-axis at 4. So that looks like it'll be letter F. If it's raised to the 3rd, it's still going to look like this. Where it's going to cross the y-axis is at 42. So you're going to look to see where that graph crosses at 42. That looks like that graph. Oh, it's negative, though. It's negative, so it's going to do this. I'm sorry. So that answer is going to be C. Then you have x to the 4th. It's going to look like a W, both going upward. That crosses at negative 20. The only one that could work would be letter B on that one. You have negative 0.3 x to the 7, so that's going to look like this somewhat. It's going to cross the x-axis at negative 5. So the only one that will work there would be letter E. And again, these graphs kind of stretch out. Remember it says they can have this many solutions. Can is the key word. It doesn't have to have that many. That's up through 12, going up through 17. No water drops in here. You're doing it wrong if you can't make it work. You do it this way. Ah, can't make it. All right, so we want to graph this function. So we're going to take a look at it. So the quick, easy way when you look at it says, hey, graph it, especially if it says graph it on, not on your graphing calculator. This means that, hey, it could cross a total of 3 times. Let's look for a greatest common factor. What can I factor out of both of those real easily? X squared, and go a little bit further, go negative x squared. And that's going to give you x plus 1, like that. Oh, x plus 2, excuse me. Does that make sense? Where does this cross the x-axis? If it's just x, or x squared by itself, where would it cross the y-axis, or x-axis? At the origin. So it's happening here. How many times will it happen there? Twice, it's raised to the second power, so it's happening there twice. So will it bounce off the x-axis or go through it? It'll bounce. Where's the other place that it'll cross the x-axis? Negative 2. Okay, where do you think this should cross the y-axis? Look at the original. Is there a constant up there? No, if there's nothing for a constant, what does the constant have to be then? 0, okay? So, because we have, this could be written as a plus 0, that's where it's crossing the y-axis. This is a negative. Remember, x to the 3rd would look like this. So negative x to the 3rd is going to be that flipped over, like that. So this particular graph is going to come down, it's going to come back up, bounce, and then come back down. And that's what that graph will look like. Number 14. We had g at x is equal to x to the 4th minus 4 x to the 3rd plus 3x squared. Things you should think about. This is raised to the 4th power. It's positive out front. So this graph is going to look like a W of some sort, like that. Okay, it doesn't always have to have the waves in the middle, but that's what the ends are going to do. Is there a greatest common factor that I can factor out of all three terms right here? X squared. That's going to leave me x squared minus 4x plus 3. Now we have to see if we can factor that. What two numbers multiply to give me positive 3, add to give me negative 4? There you go. Negative 1, negative 3. X minus 1, x minus 3. Okay, if I FOIL that back out, I'll get x squared minus 4x plus 3. Is this going to happen anywhere twice? God bless you. An origin twice. The reason is that's x squared. Okay, so this is going to say, hey, it happened here twice. Notice I don't have a constant, so it's plus 0. That's happening there still. Where else will it cross? 3 and 1, so cross at 1, here, and here. Will it go through both those points?
No.
Why not? Or why? Yeah, it will. So none of them happen twice, so it's going to go right through it. Okay, so our graph, it's going to look something like this. So I'd say it's coming down. It does a bounce right here, changes directions, comes back down here, comes back up like that. That's what that graph would look like. Okay, so again, this is working if we can factor it, okay, if it breaks down. Number 15, let's see, 15, h at x, x to the fifth minus 4x to the third, okay? This is raised to the fifth power, so sum to the fifth power should look something like this as far as a graph. Do I have a greatest common factor? I can factor out of both of these. X to the third. So how many times is it going to happen at 0? How many times will it happen at 0? 3. Will it go through or bounce? Goes right through because it's raised to an odd number. I'm left with x squared minus 4. Okay? So can this factor down further? Good. Difference 2 squares. So it's going to be x plus 2, x minus 2. Should be a 3. Let's draw our xy axis. So it's happening here. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if it's happening 3 times, it's going to go right through it. Our graph's going to look similar to that. It's also going to go through at positive 2, and it's going to go through at negative 2. So we've got to try and generate our graph to look like that. So I think we can say it's going to come up. It's going to come right through this. It's going to come back up. Notice when it goes through, we can't really see that it happened there 3 times, but it's raised to an odd number. Either the first, the third, the fifth, things like that. Number 16, we have f at x is equal to x to the third minus x. So it's x to the third. X to the third graph will look something like this as far as the end behavior goes. What can I factor out of both? X. So if I factor an x out, and then I'm left with x squared minus 1, does this factor further? Difference 2 squares, x plus 1, x minus 1. Okay? So it will go through right here one time. It's going to go through. It's also going to happen at negative 1 and at positive 1. Graph's going to look similar to that, so it's going to come up, it's going to come back down, it's going to come back up, and there's our graph. And again, these are working nicely because we can factor them. We'll get to a point where they won't factor. There's other techniques that we'll be learning how to do it. And then number 17. Do you need more time? Sorry. Okay. 17. Always do. It's the first time we ever heard it.
Sorry.
I'm giving you a hard time. You know that. Okay. Number 17 is already factored down into monomials and binomials. Okay? What exponent would this be raised to if I truly multiply the whole thing back out? Right? X to the fourth. So this is x to the fourth power if the whole thing was multiplied out. I'm not worried about the rest of it. So x to the fourth all worked out. So that'll look like this. So now where is this going to happen? Where does this happen? Where does that one happen? 0. Where does that one happen? 4. Where does this one happen? -1. Where does this one happen? +2. Good. Okay, so that's what our graph's going to be crossing. It's going to be the fourth power, so that's what it's going to look like. So this is coming down, change directions, going up. It's basically what this graph looks like. So when they're factored down, it makes it real easy to identify certain items on here. You okay so far? 19 through 25, just running through them quicker, I hope. Number 19, we have g at x is equal to negative x to the fourth minus 2x to the third. Okay, what can I factor out as the greatest common factor from both? God bless you. Negative x cubed, thanks, sir. And I got x minus or plus 2. This is x to the fourth. There's a negative out front, so it's going to look like this upside down. How many times is it going to happen at 0? 3 times. So I have 1, 2, 3. I'm just trying to show it's happening 3 times there. You don't have to make it look like a bullseye. Where else is it going to cross the x-axis? Negative 2. Okay? Will it go right through at 0 because it happened 3 times, or does it bounce? Goes right through. The bounce happens again when it's, this is to 2, 4, 6, 8. So we're going to make this graph. So it's going to do, this actually graph just looks like this. Looks like an upside down parabola for the most part. There isn't a whole lot of wiggle. Something might be happening there, but for the most part you've drawn it correctly if you've done it that way. 20. H at x is the third minus 2x. What can I factor out of both? X squared. I'm left with x minus 1. How many times will it happen at 0? X minus 3, thank you. How many times will it happen here? Twice. So is it a bounce or go through? Bounce. Where else is it going to go through the x-axis? Okay, this was x to the third power, so it's going to look like that. So we're going to come up, bounce, change direction, come back like that.
So to the second, the fourth, the sixth, the eighth, and then that will always bounce.
And then the third, you cross.
So the first, the third, the fifth goes right through. And that's the hard thing is because you can't indicate what's really taking place.
All right. Is there any others you need to see off that, or are you okay? You get the basic idea? We A-okay? All right, go ahead, and if you have multiple pages, make sure they're stapled. There's a stapler up here. Start off pretty simple. I don't think it's the hardest thing on earth. Let's say I had x squared plus 7x plus 12, and I wanted to divide this by x plus 3. Okay, now some of you might know something called synthetic division, which we'll get to, which is a valuable tool when you're dividing by binomials. But for the most part, if you were to divide this by this, if the remainder comes out to be 0, that means that x plus 3 would have been a binomial factor of the particular function. So you're going to set this up just like a normal long division problem. You have x plus 3 divided into x squared. Make sure you don't have any holes in here, meaning any gaps you have, you know, descending order. And this is how I always taught it. You have a binomial here, so you're starting at the second position over. Is that okay so far? I have a binomial, 2 terms. If I had 3 terms, I'd start 3 positions over. But I have 2 terms. Okay. What do I have to multiply times x to get x squared? X. That's okay. So if then I'm going to take x. I'm going to go x times x. I get x squared. And then I'm going to go x times 3. That's going to give me plus 3x. Now remember, you're subtracting these. So x squared minus x squared is?
Zero.
7x minus 3x. 7x minus 3x. Remember, you're subtracting them. 7x minus 3x. 4x. Bring down your last term. Okay, what do you have to multiply times x to make it 4x? 4. So, and it's positive, so I'm going to go plus 4. So positive 4 times x is 4x. Positive 4 times positive 3 is plus 12. Remember, you're subtracting these. So 4x minus 4x is 0. 12 minus 12 is 0. Is x plus 3 a factor of x squared plus 7x plus 12? Yeah, the remainder came out to 0. Okay? So what that's going to tell you is where the solutions are happening. The solutions of this problem, if I were to graph it, would cross at negative 3 and it would cross at negative 4. Where would it cross the y-axis? You want to take a shot? 12. Good. All right, let's go a little bit bigger. Can I move on, put a little more meat on the bones? Okay, let's go with 2x to the 5th plus 3x to the 4th plus 2x plus 1 divided by x squared minus 3x plus 2. So I'm dividing a trinomial into a big old polynomial. Okay, so let's set it up as a long division problem. I'm going to go x squared minus 3x plus 2 into, I got to write it without any gap, so if I have a gap, what am I going to put in place? 0, good. So I have 2x to the 5th plus 3x to the 4th plus 0x to the 3rd plus 0x squared plus 2x. Plus 1. Is that okay so far? I'm dividing by a trinomial. So how many terms do I go over to start dividing? Huh? 3. So I have 3 terms here. So I'm going to go 1, 2. I'm going to start dividing here. Okay? What do I have to multiply times x squared to make it 2x to the 5th? Remember, when you multiply polynomials, you add the exponent. So what do I have to multiply x squared by to get 2x to the 5th? 2x to the 3rd. Good. If I go 2x to the 3rd times x squared, I'm going to get 2x to the 5th. Still with me? Now I'm going to go 2x to the 3rd times negative 3x. Negative 6x what? To the 4th. Good. 2x to the 3rd times 2, 4x cubed. Everything look like it's going to line up right now? Remember, we're subtracting all these. Okay, so 2x to the 5th minus 2x to the 5th is 0. Okay, 3x to the 4th minus minus 6x to the 4th. What's minus minus mean? Plus. So 3x to the 4th plus 6x to the 4th is 9x to the 4th. Okay, 0x to the 3rd minus 4x to the 3rd. 0.
Negative 4x.
Negative 4x to the 3rd. Good. Bring down your next term. Still with me? All right, let's do some more division. What do I have to multiply times x squared to make it look like 9x to the 4th? 9x squared. 9x squared times x squared is 9x to the 4th. 9x squared times negative 3x is negative 27x to the 3rd. 9x squared times 2 is 18x squared. Remember, you're subtracting all these, right? 9x to the 4th minus 9x to the 4th is 0. Negative 4x to the 3rd minus minus 27x to the 3rd. So that becomes negative 4x to the 3rd plus 27x to the 3rd. No. 23x, right? Because it's going to be 27 minus that. So it's going to be positive 23x to the 3rd 0x squared minus 18x squared is? Minus what? Minus 18x squared. Bring down your next term. Okay, what do I have to do to x squared to make it look like 23x cubed? Times it by 23x. 23x times x squared is 23x to the third. 23x times negative 3x is negative 69x squared. Oops, I forgot that. That has a square on it. And then 23x times 2 is 46x. I'm going to run out of room. Remember, I'm subtracting. Let's do this. Okay, 23x to the third minus 23, that's 0. Negative 18x squared minus 69x squared. So negative 18x squared plus 69x squared, 51x squared. 2x minus 46x is negative 44x. Squeeze in. Okay, almost done. What do we need to do to x squared to make it 51x squared? Multiply by 51. Squeeze in, please. Okay. Yes, thank you. So bring down the 1. 51, so I'm going to bring this over here. 51x squared minus 49x plus 1. So I'm just going to do this work down here. So 51 times x squared is 51x squared. 51 times negative 3 is negative 153x. 51 times 2 is 102. Is that right? 104. Where are we looking? First one, help me out. Top? Oh, is that a 44? Thank you. All right, 51x squared minus that is going to be that. Negative 44x minus 153, so it becomes plus that, because remember, we're subtracting. Oh, shnikes. That's going to be 109 minus 103. So this is now your remainder. If this is the remainder, is this a factor of this?
No.
Now, this is what this actually is. This is, we're going to get into this in a little bit. So if this was a fifth degree polynomial, this is what this graph should look for the most part. It's going to cross here at 1. Fifth degree polynomial is going to do this for the most part, like that. What this answer is here, is called the end behavior asymptote, or the oblique asymptote. Meaning, if I were to graph that, this graph would follow this somehow, like that. And what it's doing is it follows the ends for the most part. Okay? So, our homework, you have to follow me.